In this video, we'll be troubleshooting a fail to load SELinux policy error. This problem occurred after going into rd.break mode and changing a couple of stuff. Nothing extraordinary, and I'm still not sure what's happening. In order to fix, we need to get back into a running system. Best thing to do is to start the running system with the SELinux is 0 option, because that will start with SELinux disabled. And we need to verify that the problem is really limited to SELinux alone. So here we are in the SELinux disabled mode, and we can see that logging is working correctly. So that proves that really the problem is bound to SELinux. We need to check a little bit. First, the contents of etc sysconfig SELinux, which is looking good. If you make any severe error in there, then that could be a reason why it is failing. We just need to check that that's not the case. Next, a couple of more checks. Etc shadow is showing no context label. That is expected behavior, because we don't have an SELinux. And next, the .auto-relabel file. I had created the .auto-relabel file, and apparently that's not doing what it's supposed to do. So let me remove that and see if the error is there, and then reboot again, because you never know. And you know, I have no clue what's happening. And if you have no clue what's happening, you need to apply the troubleshooting methodology get information. Already I want to know if there is an RPM that contains the SELinux policy. That is going to be my second line of attack. Just remove the RPM and reinstall the RPM. So we can see SELinux policy targeted is the name of the RPM. We will keep that in mind, and we are going to reboot. So we are just checking now if the removal of the .auto-relabel makes a difference. Probably not, but hey, you need to gather some evidence. And there we can see failed to load SELinux policy, it's still freezing. So let's restart again. And in the restarted mode, we need to start the server with SELinux is 0 again, which makes sure that SELinux is completely unloaded. So it's in disabled state. And again, we are able to log in. And let's just check the name of the RPM again, and we remove it. You remove SELinux policy targeted. So we can see that there's some dependencies. Notice that the container stuff is a dependency as well. So we don't have any builder anymore. We don't have any Popman anymore. So at a later stage, we really need to reinstall the container packages. But that's of a later worry. The first worry is to get the system up again with the SELinux stuff running. So the package has been removed. And we need to check the contents of etc SELinux. We can see that lots of stuff is still around. And we need to remove that stuff, because I don't know exactly what exactly the error was in. So rm-rf SELinux will remove the entire subdirectory so that it can be recreated when we are after the reboot. So now at this point we need to verify that we can still boot properly. I need to set SELinux is 0. In fact, I didn't need to do that, because we just removed the configuration file, but hey, never mind. We just need to make sure that we are in a state where SELinux is disabled, so that we can reinstall the SELinux package again. So back to the root prompt and yum install SELinux policy targeted, which is the name of the default targeted policy on this CentOS 8.2 system. Do notice that while it removed many more packages in the dependencies that it's installing, it's not installing the container packages. For my current configuration, that doesn't hurt because I don't have any containers. But it's still something to consider and which we may need to troubleshoot later afterwards. So now that the policy is installed again, we need to reboot once more. And in this reboot, we are going to reboot with SC-Linux just enabled. As you see, I didn't do anything on the group bootloader menu. And given as far as it is right now, this is looking kind of good. Oh, and look at that. We can see that SC-Linux has noticed that something weird has happened. So it's telling us that policy relabel is required. I like the policy relabel because after all we mess around a lot and we want to make sure that all of the file system is consistent with what we see in SC-Linux. So we just need to sit this out and wait a little bit. At this moment you can see it's giving an interesting error, and that is an error on the container varlib t context. That context doesn't come from the SC-Linux policy targeted package, it comes from one of the container packages. Here we can see it is being slow, and it's always wise to wait a little bit. But if you analyze what is happening, it has already issued the reboot, and we can see systemd shutdown trying to talk to the processors, but nothing is happening anymore. And as the relabel seems to be quite far, I'm giving it a restart right now. So that's the normal boot procedure, no more stuff that needs to be entered on the boot prompt. And back to the login shell. We are logging in as root again. After all, we messed up the etc shadow context, and as we can see, that is okay. So let's do a couple of checks. Before this problem, I have worked with a slash web directory as a non-default document root for Apache. And look at that, the context still exists. I also have started Apache on port 82, and look at that, it's still running on port 82. And that means that even after I have removed the entire etc SC-Linux configuration, everything seems to be okay again. That's kind of miraculous, because in etc SC-Linux targeted context files there is this this file context local file, and this file context local file still contains the policy that I've used. To be honest, beats me, but apparently it's stored somewhere else as well. It's working again.